Over the last few months, Todoist has been quietly working away at how the subtasks work. And this week I want to go into that into a little bit more detail so that you can get or find the full benefits of using subtasks in Todoist Foundations. Now, this is only going to work if you have upgraded since October last year, if you're using the new Todoist Foundations, came out October last year, and that you are using the latest version of Todoist. So make sure before you try any of these trips, things that I'm going to show you this week, make sure you actually update your Todoist to the latest version. Now, before we go any further, I would just like to say, if you get any value from this episode, then please help me by hitting that like button below. And if you haven't subscribed to my channel yet, and you want to get all the latest tips, tricks, and news on Todoist, then please subscribe to my channel. Okay, let me take you into Todoist now, and I will show you everything you need to know about using subtasks with Todoist. Okay, so here I have a task, a parent task called Set Up New Business, and underneath I have three subtasks or three child tasks. Now, there's a number of things that we can do here. So if I just go into this one, sorry, if I just close this and I just tap on there, that's going to take me into the task view, and we can see the subtasks down here. So set up new business, and the subtasks are open bank account, hire an accountant, and get company registered. Now, there's some interesting things that go on right here. Let's take, for example, that I schedule this parent task for today. Let's schedule that for today. Now, I'm not going to schedule these at all. I'm just scheduling today for the parent task. Close that. Let's look at today's view. And we've got set up new business, and I have the subtasks underneath, which have no date attached to them. So that's the first thing that to remember, is you can actually set up the parent task, and you can give it a date. And it don't have to give the three tasks underneath, but they will come up in the today view. Now, let's go into this again, and let's just close this out, and we'll say no date for this one, but we're going to add a date for the open bank account. So we click that for today, and we can close the task. So there's no date for the setup new business or the other two subtasks, it's just this one. What happens then? Well, in today's view now, we just have open bank account. It's just set there. There's nothing else in there. It's just open the bank account. And that's it. Now, this is attached to the inbox. It's the task that's in the inbox. It is the same one. If I go back over here and click on there, it is the only one that has a date, and that is the only task that comes up. So that's something just to keep in mind when you're setting up the subtask. They do act a little differently from a parent task in the past. They didn't work in exactly that same way. Now, what happens when you check a task off? Now, this was something that's changed in a recent update. What happens now is almost immediately it will disappear, but it will come back. So I can just tap on there, and I can tap on there, and now they've disappeared. Now, what I would do is I can go into here, and it will now show me that these tasks. So it depends which view that you are in. So we'll uncheck those. Let's go that. So if we're going to check off these tasks from this view, then they're going to disappear immediately. But if we're into this view and I check them off, what you'll notice is they appear underneath. Oops, they appear underneath immediately, and they stay here. The only thing is they don't grey out now, but it does. It is pretty obvious that those tasks are actually now checked off. So for those of you who are following the time boxing system and you want to manage your projects, now this is a possibility that you could do. You could create your projects within the time boxes. Now, personally, I'm going to say right now, this is not how I envisage the time boxing system. The time boxing system does away with projects. This could get very, very messy if you think, ah, I can use this as a project. You've got to, if you want time boxes to work for you, you have to let go of that concept of projects. It's one of the most liberating things you can do, but I know I haven't convinced everyone on that yet. But there you go. That's one way that you can do with setting up these sub projects. This is how Todoist is actually operating them now. And I actually really quite like this idea. You can go into here and I can, so when I tick on that, there's no subtask showing at all. But what I can do now is I can go into there and they are showing that I have done. And of course, just in the past, you can actually just uncheck those when I uncheck them. And then we check off here, they all come back into there and there they are. So it's just something to keep in mind when you're using the subtask and the parent task. They're a great way. I am actually using this for setting up my new business because of the current lockdown situation. Things are being very, very slow to get the business set up. The company is registered and they do have an accountant hired. I'm just waiting for all the bank details to come through so I can get operating properly. But this is why I'm using this as an example. But this is a very good way of using it. I could have kept all this independent. It really wouldn't matter. But it is a nice way just to keep everything all in one place. And as you say, sometimes you do want to know what's done. To be honest, I only have these three tasks. I don't really need to know what's done. I know what's been done. So there you go. That's really all you need to know about the subtasks and how they work. I hope you found this useful. They have been updated recently. The main update, to be fair with you, was just this. Now these are instantaneously, they've just completely disappeared. Ah, because I've just got into the task. Let's go back to the main parent. Ah, by the way, if you do that, I should just quickly, before we finish, if I click on that, you notice, I've gone somewhere. All you have to do is click on this bit section here, which does take you back to the main task. And as I say, this is the main thing that's changed in a recent update, is now they instantaneously show up on your list. So there you go. Thank you very much for watching this episode. It just remains for me now to wish you all a very, very productive week. Well, thank you very much for watching this video. Now, I have a question for you. Are you ready to go beyond the to-do list? Now, I ask that question because building a to-do list, building an organization system is really the first step to mastering the art of productivity. If you really want to take yourself to the next level and you really want to automate the whole process, then you need to start using workflows. You need to start building workflows because it's the work that you do consistently over a period of time that completes projects, achieves goals, and takes you to accomplish the things that you really want to accomplish in your life. And that's why I developed my Productivity Masterclass series, Building Your Very Own Custom Workflows. Now, this is a course that is kind of on the advanced level. It's designed to get you to go beyond the to-do list, which many of us have spent many hours building. And it's designed to take you to the very next level so that your whole system is automated so you can make decisions really quickly about what it is you want to do today, this week, this month, and this year, and build it into your daily workflows that takes you towards accomplish them. Now, I would love to see you in this course. The details of my Productivity Masterclass course, Building Your Very Own Custom Workflows, are in the show notes below. I would love to see you in the course. I'm sure you will not be disappointed. It'd be great for you to join us. Thank you very much for watching this. It just remains for me now to wish you again a very, very productive week.